is just one of those days that I'm having all the trouble in the world filming and I don't know why. I sometimes wake up and I'm like really on it and really ready to film and just feeling really good. And then some days I wake up and I'm tripping over all of my words and I can't get anything out, and today is one of those days, so please bear with me. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Jess. Today I wanted to film the guilty reader tag. I've been seeing this floating around a lot on BookTube and I really, really like it. And I thought it was a really interesting tag, so I wanted to go ahead and sit down and film that for you guys. I'm gonna tag a couple people down below. I don't know if anyone has done this. I'm still trying to catch up on BookTube. I have like weeks worth of videos to watch that I haven't like caught up on. So I'm sorry if I'm tagging you've already done this, just let me know. But I hope you guys are having a good week and let's go ahead and just get started. All right, so I have all the questions here on my phone. The first question is, have you ever re-gifted a book that you've been given? I don't think that I've ever re-gifted a book to somebody that I've been given. However, I have donated books that I have been given or gifted. Most of the time people know what I like and what I don't like, and sometimes they're like, hey, I saw this book and I thought of you and I will read it, but not necessarily want to keep the book. So usually what I'll do is just donate it or sell it. I don't necessarily like re-gift it to somebody. I'm not the type of person to re-gift gifts. Question number two is, have you ever said you've read a book when you haven't? No, I'm very honest about that. If I haven't read a book, I will tell you I haven't read a book. I'm very honest about what I have and haven't read. So I'm not the type of person to be like, yes, I've read that book, because I like to talk about books and I think it's funny when people are like, oh yeah, I read that book, and then you try to talk to them about it and they're like, I have no idea what you're talking about, I have not actually read that book. So I'm very honest when it comes to what I have and haven't read. Question number three, have you ever borrowed a book and not returned it? Yeah, from the library. I was living in Ohio, and I borrowed a bunch of books from the library because I was going home to Alaska to visit some family there. Well, I ended up staying in Alaska for like a good year, I think, and eventually the library was just like, all right, cut their losses and charge me for all of the books that I had taken, and I never did return them. I honestly don't own any of them anymore, but I definitely did not return any of the like 16 books that I borrowed, and I feel awful about that. I want to become a partner of the library just to like donate money and like feel better about having thiefed like 16, 17 books. Question number four, have you ever read a series out of order? No, technically I haven't. However, the Robin Hobb books, like the Rainwild Chronicles, I guess there is a certain way that you're supposed to read Robin Hobb books, and I did not know that. I had read the entire Rainwild Chronicles, like back to back, I read all four of the books, but I learned recently from a friend that you're actually supposed to read certain books in certain order, like certain series, but I don't honestly think that you have to do that with these books, so I'm gonna go ahead and say no. But if you wanna be a stickler, then yes, I would say the Robin Hobb books, I read those out of order. Question number five, have you ever spoiled a book for someone? Not that I know of, but you know, I can never be 100% sure. I do have like a Bookstagram account and we do post about our books on there. Maybe I've spoiled it that way. I've obviously posted like spoilery reviews on BookTube, so if somebody's watched that, then yes, I've spoiled it that way, but never ever intentionally. Question number six, have you ever doggy-eared a book? Yes, I have. Back in the day, I used to doggy-ear all my books. It was a terrible habit. I would not recommend it. I actually broke myself of that habit when my husband and I got married, because he was like, what are you doing? Stop doing that to your book. Question number seven, have you ever told someone you don't own a book when you do? No, I am never ashamed of any of the books that I'm reading. I don't tend to really read weird books or anything like that, which is a little bit shocking for me, honestly. I'm really open to read whatever, but if someone is like, hey, do you own this book? Even if most people are ashamed of owning it, I would still be like, yes, I own that book. Because life's too short really to give a hell what anyone else thinks about the books that you're reading. Question number eight, have you ever told someone you haven't read a book when you have? No, because like tying into the last one, I'm not ashamed of anything that I read. So if someone's like, hey, have you read this super raunchy, terrible book? I would be like, yeah, I read it, and this is what I thought of it. Like, I don't know, books are written to appeal to all different types of people. So for me, it's like, why be ashamed? Someone out there has read this really ridiculous book that you absolutely loved and liked it. So why lie about it? Question number nine, have you ever skipped a chapter or a section of a book? No, I have not. I do skim, but I don't skip, if that makes sense. Skimming is sort of just like reading and picking up bits and pieces as you go. Skipping would be just like, okay, like especially for multiple POVs, like people go, okay, this is a character that I don't like, I'm gonna skip this entire chapter. And I feel like that's a little weird because you're missing out on so much of the story. Like, yes, you may not like them, but you're still missing out. So I will skim and get from chapters what I want. I don't often do this. I think in my lifetime I've done this with like 10 or 12 books, but that's such a random number, 10 or 12, but I know which books I'm talking about, so it's like a handful of books that I've done that to, but most of the time I will read a book from start to finish. If I don't enjoy it, really, then I just DNF it. Like, why skip stuff? Why not just be done with the book? And number 10, have you ever badmouthed a book you actually liked? No. If I don't like a book, I will tell you I don't like a book. Or if in the off chance that you hate it and I like it, I will still tell you that I do or I don't. Because I'm really, really honest, like I said, about the books that I do and don't like. I don't care, honestly, what anyone thinks. I've always been that way when it comes to the books that I read. I've been reading adult books since I was in elementary school, and a lot of the time my teachers were like, you shouldn't be reading that, blah blah blah, and I just didn't care. And I don't care, I guess that kind of set it off. I don't care what anyone thinks about any of the books that I read, so I would never ever lie about that. Alright guys, that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I don't know if you guys can kind of feel it, but I think fall is in the air. One leaf changed in my front yard. One leaf changed, and I was like, fall's here. September 1st, Harry's back at school. I am all in fall mode. Everything is very comfy, cozy. I don't know if you guys ever get that way, but I love being cozy. I love when it's like cold out and it's like rainy out, or it's like more cooler out and it's like you're bundled up sitting on your couch with like something warm and a blanket. I don't know why, but that really, really appeals to me. I absolutely love fall. And I don't really know how the weather is where you guys are, but that's totally the mode I'm in, so expect a little bit more of that from this channel over the next coming weeks. But I hope you guys are having a good week, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye!